Hello YouTube. Today what we're going to be doing is I'm going to show you how to download and use Next Video Converter to convert your videos or music files to any other thing. I'm going to be converting a QuickTime or a .mov file today to WMV because I want to use it in Movie Maker and Windows Media Player. I already have a video made just for this video, a test video that we're going to be converting. But first of all, what we're going to want to do to get Next Video Converter is go to Google or any other search engine and type in Next Video Converter. Okay. Now you come up here. He's probably the first one. Usually is. Okay. Now, you gotta go find what one you want. You go up here, you get the free version, unless you want to pay for it. And then you come down here, and you click free download. Now, since I've already done it, I'm not going to do this. But what you're going to want to do is just click save file. And then if you're using Firefox, you just open it up. And then what you got to do is just use the setup wizard. But now that you have Next Video Converter all downloaded, I'm going to minimize this and open it up, as you can see right here. Now, what you want to do is add movie. I'm gonna go back. Just gonna go find the one that I want. Go to pictures. That's where all my movie is. Test. Here it is. So, as you can see, this is a QuickTime file, so I can't play it in Movie Maker or Windows Media Player. So that's what I want to do. I want to change it to WMV. So I'm just gonna go double click it. And you click whatever file that you want to put it in, whatever you want to make it. I usually use WMV7. Okay. So now that everything is gone, you checked everything. Go up here to start. And you're just gonna want to wait for it to just load up with stuff. I'm just gonna pause it right here, and I'll be back. Okay, since we're almost done, I'm just going to unpause it, and here we are, almost at 100%. Okay, current version is 3. That is just an ad if you want to upgrade your Next Video Converter. I do not want to do that, so you press no. And now, Next Video Converter will automatically take you to the folder that you specified that you want your video to be in. It's probably most likely going to be in the Next Video Converter file under OSC, under C drive. And here it is. As you can see now, it's a Windows Media Player. I'm going to open up in Movie Maker now, so I'm just going to X this out. And X this out. Go up to my Movie Maker. Come on. There we go, Movie Maker. Wait for that to load up. Just gonna remove that. And go to Import Media. You gotta go, make sure you go to the OSC and then click Next Video Converter and then it will be in this folder. Here it is. You see it's loading up. And there you go. There's no error message or anything. You actually got your QuickTime video in the Next Video is now in Movie Maker. And it works perfectly. Quality is actually surprisingly good for an iPod.
Hey guys, this is TechEd Joe here today. And this is just basically your regular test video for the how to use Next Video Converter.
I'm just gonna play that video just to show you how there's no errors in the video. So here it is.
If you're putting this video on YouTube, you will be seeing this video within the video of the Next Video Converter. I'm just using this as a test because I need a video to convert from QuickTime to WMV. Okay? So that will be all. I'm just gonna wait until I get to at least 50 seconds, maybe it's 30 more seconds, just as a good time. Galaxy is really, really good. I'm just gonna go put it in the mirror for you. See, recording from my iPad. As you can see there, it works really well. So, yeah. Okay, I'm at a minute now. See ya.
And so as you can see, that video is a little bit choppy, but it's from an iPod, so it's pretty great. Anyways, that was my tutorial on how to download and use Nexio Converter. Thank you, and subscribe. Please subscribe if you like my videos. I know you like my videos. Everyone likes my videos. See ya.